As I attempt to build this Shanghai World Financial Center model from pictures, I want to say that please keep in mind that this is for 3D printing. So, enjoy the video. The Shanghai World Financial Center is a super tall skyscraper located in Pudong District of Shanghai, a building above a height of 300 meters or 984 feet is considered a super tall skyscraper. This financial center was designed by Conn Peterson Fox and developed by the Mori Building Company, with Leslie E. Robertson Associates as its structural engineer, China State Construction Engineering Corporation, and Shanghai Construction General Company as its main contractors. It is a mixed-use skyscraper consisting of offices, hotels, conference rooms, observation decks, and ground floor shopping malls. Park Hyatt Shanghai is the tower's hotel component, comprising of 174 rooms and suites occupying the 79th to the 93rd floor, which at the time of completion was the highest hotel in the world. On September 14, 2007, the skyscraper was completed at 492 meters or 1,614 feet, making it the 12th tallest building in the world and the 4th tallest structure in mainland China. The Shanghai World Financial Center opened to the public on August 28, 2008, featuring 101 separate floors, with its highest observation deck on the 100th floor. The observation deck offers views from 474 meters or 1,555 feet tall above the ground level. The Shanghai World Financial Center has been lauded for its design, and in 2008 it was named by architects as the year's best completed skyscraper. In 2013, it was exceeded in height by the adjacent Shanghai Tower, which was just built adjacent to it. Together, the Shanghai World Financial Center, the Shanghai Tower, and the Jin Mao Tower form the world's first adjacent grouping of three super tall skyscrapers. If you're traveling to Shanghai, now that I'm suggesting you to go there during this current pandemic, you're able to visit all three skyscrapers in just one afternoon. They're that close. The elevators in the Shanghai World Financial Center are the fastest in the world, moving at an impressive speed of 10 meters per second. They can travel between the first floor and the 95th floor in just 1 minute. Still, it can cost you around 440 yuan or 83 Canadian. In my opinion, visiting one is sufficient for me since all the views are very much similar. The history of the building. First, let's talk about the Pudong District. The reform and opening up of Pudong, Shanghai was declared in 1919, and since then, the creation of a completely new city has begun in the area, which is on the other side of the river from the Puxi area, the Shanghai's traditional city center. Shanghai had more vitality than Beijing, and the whole city was full of excitement. It was full of lively energy attempting to achieve economic development in places where there was nothing. With regard to the Shanghai World Financial Center, construction initially began in 1997 by the Mori Building Company, but due to the Asian financial crisis which occurred at that time, construction was suspended at the point where the work on the underground piles was completed. Subsequently, the design was revised to meet the latest specifications demanded by international financial institutions, and in 2003, construction resumed. It was also because of this change that the original plan for a 460 meter tall building was scrapped in favor of the new higher 490 meter tall building. The Mori Building Company utilized its development and management know-how to create the Shanghai World Financial Center, which stands there today. In 2008, construction completed and the tower was opened. Having 101 floors, various businesses and enterprises entered the building and set up a shop. At this time, it was the tallest building in China, until the Shanghai Tower officially finished construction in 2015 at just over 140 meters tall. Luckily, the building's unique shape and design already set it apart from other buildings in the city, And still, to this day, is one of the most visited sightseeing towers in Shanghai. The tower itself is owned by many different international companies, with Morgan Stanley having coordinated the investment plans. Despite being located in China, companies from China, Japan, the US, and Europe were also involved in the financing of the building. Design and construction. In the original design of the Shanghai World Financial Center, the iconic huge aperture was intended to be circular shaped. Such a design was inspired by the ancient Chinese philosophy of round sky and square earth. Additionally, the empty circular hole of the Shanghai World Financial Center, together with the spheres on the nearby Oriental Pearl Tower and Shanghai International Conference Center, form a distinctive contrast of solid and void. However, this was opposed heavily by the local people, including the mayor, claiming that the circular aperture is too similar to the icon on the Japanese national flag. Since then, Kong Pedersen Fox Associates changed the design to the trapezoid one we see today. As an added bonus, it became more convenient and cheaper to construct this trapezoid design. The Shanghai World Financial Center resembles a giant square column in which two of its sides have been beveled from opposite corners, starting about one-third of the way up, and gradually taper closer together until they nearly meet and form a narrow rectangle at the top. The building is supported by large diagonally braced corner columns of mixed structural steel and reinforced concrete in the outer wall, and the reinforced concrete inner core wall. The two structures are connected by a series of radiating beams at intervals where horizontal truss bands encircle the exterior. The exterior sheathing is a curtain wall of double-paned mirror glass. The large trapezoid-shaped opening near the top of the tower acts to reduce the wind load on the building. In addition, two damper units with 150-ton counterweight are installed at the 90th floor level to reduce the sway of the tower from lateral wind forces. Also, the building is designed to withstand earthquakes and high winds from typhoons. Traveling to the Shanghai World Financial Center. If you are at the Bund looking for a way to cross the river to visit the Shanghai World Financial Center Tower, there are no bridges nearby to cross the river. However, there are three other ways to cross. Number 1. By riding the subway. This is the most common way. The Shanghai Metro is currently the largest rapid transit system in the world by route length, so taking the subway in Shanghai is a common practice. You can first go to Nanjing Road, then enter any subway station that is nearest to you. Then take Line 2, get off at Luzhaizui Station, find the number 6 exit to exit the station. After that, it's only a 5 to 10 minute walk to arrive at the Shanghai World Financial Tower. Another way is you can get off the subway at Dongchang Road Station, exit the station from the number 4 exit, then it's a 5 minute walk to arrive at the tower. Number 2, by riding the ferry. This is probably the cheapest, scenic, but also very cumbersome way. You can go to the Bund port and purchase a ticket to ride the ferry for only 2 yuan to get to Luzhaizui. In this way, you can appreciate the scenery on the river. These ferries are public transportation that serve similar functions as public buses. After getting off the ferry, you need to walk for about 8 minutes to get to the Shanghai World Financial Center. Number 3, and the simplest way, take a taxi. If you don't want the hassle to memorize Chinese characters or simply afraid of getting lost, you can always just get there by riding a taxi. There is a tunnel under the river for private vehicles and taxis to travel through. Visiting attractions in the tower. Located on the 100th floor, the top observation deck is one of the highest observation decks in Shanghai. At over 470 meters above ground level, the views of the city from here are awe-inspiring. This is especially true at night when the sun has gone down and the lights of Shanghai comes out. At the top observation deck, you'll be greeted by a 55-meter-long skywalk complete with a glass roof. It will make you feel as though you're walking on clouds. On the 97th floor is another observation deck open to the public. Landing here is a little bit cheaper than going all the way to the top. Plus, you get pretty much the same view. This viewing platform also happens to be the highest open-air viewing platform in the world. That means you can take the impressive Shanghai sights whilst feeling the wind against your face. Make sure to bring something warm to wrap up in, just in case. On this floor, there is also the 100th Century Avenue restaurant. This restaurant is a perfect place to enjoy a high-quality meal whilst taking in the sights. Moreover, the restaurant itself is known for producing some of the finest cuisine in Shanghai. A third observation deck is on the 94th floor, and is the lowest of the observation decks. It is the largest and most comfortable of the observation decks. There is a lounge here for relaxing along with refreshments. Occasionally, there are events and exhibitions which take place on this floor, so even if you decide to opt for the more expensive 100th floor observation deck, make sure to check and see what's happening here. Another area of the hotel which is perfect for seeing the city is the Park Hyatt Hotel lobby. It sits on the 87th floor and comes complete with a nice cocktail bar for enjoying a drink whilst gazing over the wonder of the city. Printing of this model wasn't successful at all. There were a bunch of problems either with the printer or the filament. As you can see, I've broken this model into three pieces and the bottom section printed fine. However, when I tried to print the middle two sections, the thermistor died on my Prusa i3 Mark III, and it basically wasn't fixable. I had to order new thermistors. And with the current situations around the world, that shipping might take a long time to get here. Thus, I started printing this model using my TiVo Tornado. However, somehow I couldn't get any successful prints for a while due to the extruder strafing the filament, or one time I simply ran out of filament and wasn't present to feed more in. Also, by this time I ran out of gray filament, so I had to use black to print and also reprint the bottom section again because the color didn't match. Still, in the end, I did finally finish printing this, just used a lot more time than expected. If I had spare thermistors or maybe been more prudent with filament checking, then I might have gotten this done earlier. I hope you guys learned something from this video. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that subscribe button down below, and I hope to see you guys in my next video. Bye for now.